Hello students, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is circles. Okay, already we have seen some basic information in class 8, in class 7th. Okay, so today we are going to study, from today onwards we are going to study the same topic with more details. Okay, so this is the first period, so we will put a glance on the basic information which we have taken in the previous classes. Okay, so here we are going to see factors of circle. Okay, so first this is circle. Okay, what is mean by circle? Okay, circle means it is the collection of points. It is the collection of points in the plane. Okay, these are the points. It is the collection of points in the planes from a fixed point. From a fixed point, this is fixed point at a constant distance. From a fixed point at a constant distance. So this is the fixed point, and this all the points, the distance between this point and this point or points on the circumference is constant. Okay, so this is a general definition of a circle. Understood? So now second, first thing is, first factor of the circle is, first part of the circle is center. What is mean by center? Center means it is the fixed point. Center is the fixed point. Okay, and the distance from this point and circumference is constant. Wherever you will take distance about this circle, that distance will be constant. Okay, so this is the center of the circle, and generally we denote by O, or any letter we can use, but generally we use O letter for the center of the circle. Okay, next thing is radius. Radius means the distance from the center of the circle to the circumference or boundary. Okay, center of the circle to the circumference. So this is the radius. So O, and this is suppose A, then OA is equal to, this is OA is radius. Okay, and generally we denote by small r. Okay, radius we denote by small r. Okay, so the distance from the center and the circumference is equal to the line segment which is showing the distance from the center and the circumference is known as a radius of the circle, and we denote by r. Okay, next thing is chord. What is mean by chord? Chord is a line segment which is joining two points on the circumference. Okay, so this is the chord of the circle. Okay, suppose this point is A and B. A and B are on the circumference or on the boundary. So AB is a chord. Okay, like that many chords we can take for a circle. Understood? Then this is center of the circle. Okay, we have studied center, a line which is passing through the center of circle, that is also a chord, but there is a specific name for that, that is diameter. Understood? So circumference means what? A line segment which is joining two points on the circumference, that is known as chord. Okay, so next thing is diameter. Just now I told you diameter means what? Diameter is also a chord. Diameter is also a chord, but that chord is passing through the center of circle. That chord is passing through the center of circle. Suppose this is the center of circle, and a line segment which is joining the two points on the circumference or on the boundary. Suppose this is A, B, and this is O. Okay, so AB is equal to diameter. AB is known as diameter here. Okay, because that is passing through the center of the circle. So diameter is also a chord, but it is passing through the center of circle, so it is called as diameter. Understood? And diameter we denote by d, small d. Okay, and the relation between radius and diameter we have studied. What is the relation between radius and diameter? Radius, diameter is equal to 2 times of radius. Diameter is equal to 2 times of radius. Means AB is equal to AO plus OB. AO and OB are same because these are the radii of the same circle. Okay, radii of the same circle are always equal. Understood? Now next point is arc. Okay, so arc, this is the new factor for you. So see carefully what is mean by arc. Suppose this is a continuous portion. Arc means what? Continuous portion. Suppose I am taking here A, B, C, D, E, F. okay. So AB, this distance, this is the continuous portion, this distance is equal to the arc, is equal to the arc. So arc, how we can write arc AB? Suppose I want to show arc AB, then arc we denote by this sign. So arc AB, okay. And generally we use anti-clockwise system. Suppose I want to measure, suppose see here, one more circle I am taking here. This is P and this is Q. This is P and Q. Suppose I want to show arc PQ, arc PQ. Anti-clockwise means this way it will go. Okay. Suppose I want to show this distance P to Q, then how I will show arc PQ. But suppose I want to show from Q to P, Q to P. Okay. That time I cannot use PQ. Okay. I need to show QP, arc PQ. QP. So that time I will show QRQP. Okay. Means here QP, the distance of QP is greater than the PQ. Understood. So this way we need to show. Okay. So arc means what? That is a continuous portion of the circumference or boundary. That is known as arc of the circle. Okay. So next thing is, next point is circumference. Circumference we have studied. Okay. Circumference means the perimeter of circle. Circumference means what? In short, we can say perimeter of circle is equal to the circumference of circle. Okay. So, circumference we denote by 2 pi r. This distance is equal to circumference. Understood? So, circumference is equal to, we use formula 2 pi r. Okay. With the help of this, we can find out the perimeter of circle. That is known as circumference of the circle. Okay. Pi. This is pi, 22 by 7. Okay. What is pi, that we have seen already. Okay, so 2 pi r is the formula which we are using for the circumference. Okay, so now next thing is concentric circle. Concentric circle means what? See here. Here circle is given and center is given. Okay, with the help of same center, suppose I will take one more circle, but radius is different. Radius is different. Okay, if this radius is 4 centimeter, this is 1 centimeter. Okay, suppose I will take with the help of same center, I will take one more circle like that. Suppose this radius is 2 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 4 centimeter, like that. If we will take circles with the help of same center, then such type of circles are known as concentric circles. Such type of circles are known as concentric circle of the concentric circles. Understood? Next is segment. This is also new factor for you, new point for you, segment. Okay, suppose I will take here a chord. This is chord. Okay, I will say here chord AB. Chord AB. Okay, so due to chord AB, the circle is divided into two parts. Circle is divided into two parts. Okay, so this is one of the, from that, this is the, this is one part and this is second part. Okay, so these are known as segments. This is minor segment and this is major segment. Okay, this is minor segment. Why minor segment? Because its arc AB, arc AB is smaller than arc VA. Okay, arc AB is smaller than arc BA. Just now I told you it goes anti-clockwise. So AB means from point A to B and BA means from B to A. Understood? So AB, this distance AB is shorter than BA. So this is minor arc and this is major arc. So here we can say minor arc or minor segment and this is major segment. Understood? These things we are going to use in the theorem. Okay, so see carefully, then we can use for the proof. Okay, so next, see central angle means, see here, just now I told you here about arc. Okay, so here I am taking here arc PQ and this is the center of the circle. Okay, so center, this arc PQ, suppose I will join this P with this center and Q also. Okay, the arc PQ is due to RPQ, a central angle is formed here. Suppose this angle, this is, I am saying O, and this is suppose 60 degree. Okay, so here the measure of PQ, measure of RPQ, we can say 60 degree, measure of RPQ is 60 degree. Okay, so this is known as central angle because it is in the center. Okay, it is made up of, it is made up with center. So that is known as central angle of the circle. Okay, next thing is sector. This is very important point, sector. Okay, so see here, the same thing we are going to use here. Suppose again here P and here Q, PQ, and this is the center of the circle. So POQ is the sector of the circle. POQ is the sector of the circle. This is the minor sector. This is minor sector. Okay, minor sector. And this is major sector. This is major sector because this angle is formed, this sector is formed with the help of PQ, which is smaller than QP, which is smaller than RQP. Understood? So this is minor sector and this is major sector. Suppose minor sector is given 60 degree, minor sector is given 60 degree, and I want to find out major of this sector, big sector, major sector. Okay, measurement of major sector, that time how we can do? This is, we know that this is whole angle 360 degree. From 360 we will subtract 60 degree, then automatically we will get this answer, that is 300. 360 degree minus this 60 degree, so that is 300 degree. So this is, this angle is 300. Okay, so this way we can find out major segment, major sector. Okay, now these are the basic things which we have seen. Okay, from that some concepts you have learned in the previous classes. Okay, so once again see, this is the circle. Okay, circle is the collection of points in the plane which are equidistant from the center, which are all points are equidistant from the center, that is known as circle. Okay, second thing, center of the circle, that we denote by O generally, and it is equidistant from all the points on the boundary. Okay, now radius is the distance between center to the boundary or circumference. Next thing is chord is a line segment which is joining two points on the circumference or boundary, that is known as chord. Like that, many chords we can draw. Okay, now diameter is also a chord, but it is passing through the center of circle, so it is known as diameter of the circle. Okay, next is arc is the continuous portion of the circumference. Okay, so AB, this is a small piece, so AB is an arc. We use a clockwise system for this. Suppose I want to show this arc, then how we can do? BA means this distance, and here BA is greater than the AB. Okay, so that is a part of the circumference. Next thing is circumference. Circumference is means the perimeter of the circle, and we use to find for this 2 pi r. Okay, so this is circumference. Then concentric circle. Concentric circle means with the help of same center, if different circles are drawn with the different radius, then those circles are known as concentric circles. Okay, then segment. Okay, here AB is drawn. AB is a chord. Due to AB, this circle is divided into two parts, two segments. We can say segments. So this is minor segment. This is major segment. Suppose this is AB is diameter, then both the segments will be equal. Okay, semicircles, that will be, this is semicircle, this will be semicircle. The circle will be divided into two equal parts. Okay, when AB is the diameter. Okay, second, next thing is central angle. Central angle is, this is arc. Okay, the angle which is made up by the arc with the center, that is known as central angle of the circle. Okay, next is sector. Sector means the same point, this distance. This distance is known as sector. Okay, so sector means what? Angle which is made up by this arc with the center, that piece is known as sector. Okay, we can take an example for this pizza. Okay, if you will take a cut from this, then that is the sector of that pizza. Okay, so that is a good example for sector. Okay, so I told you how to find out the measurement of another sector, that is alternate sector also we can say, if major sector is given or minor sector is given. Okay, next is that arc we have seen already. So these are the basic points which are required to learn this chapter properly. Understood? So see carefully, and all the definitions and everything is given in your textbook. So take the reference from your textbook also. Hello students, today we are going to see first activity from the circle. Okay, that name of the activity is angles subtended by a chord. Okay, just now we have seen what is chord. Okay, so with the help of that we are going to see activity. The name of the activity is angles subtended by a chord. Okay, for this I have taken a circle. Okay, see carefully, because afterwards you have to do this activity in the lab manual. Okay, so see carefully, I have taken a circle. Okay, with a radius r. Okay, so see carefully, now I am showing here. So first we will draw a chord. Okay, that chord means what is mean by chord? Chord means a line segment which is joining two points on the circumference. So this point I am saying, this is A and this point is B. So this is chord AB. Okay, this is the center of the circle. So center of the circle generally we denote by O. Okay, so chord AB and O, and name of the activity is angle subtended by a chord. Okay, so here if we are thinking about the chord, then this chord can make an angle with the center, that is known as central angle, okay. So if I will join this BO, and OA, then one angle is formed in the center. Okay, so that is, this angle we can write by AOB, angle AOB. Okay, which is made by the chord. Okay, now we are going to see angle subtended by a chord. Suppose I will take any point on the circumference. Circumference means the perimeter of the circle. Okay, so if I will take any point on the circumference, so that point I am saying here C. Anywhere you can take on the circumference. Okay, and this C point I will join now with the point A and B once again. Okay, AC and here BC. AC and BC. Okay, so now what is our target? What we are going to find out? We are going to find out the relation between angle AOB, means this angle, and ACB. Okay, we are going to find out relation between AOB and ACB. Okay, so that is the name of the activity is angle subtended by the chord. This angle is also subtended by chord AB, and this angle is also subtended by chord AB. Like that, many angles we can form. Okay, this C point you can take here, anywhere on the border. Okay, but the property, the result will be same. Okay, so see here carefully, this angle, if easily you can see, then you will get that angle ACB is shorter than angle AOB. Okay, see here, angle ACB, here I am taking that result, angle ACB is shorter than angle AOB, but what is the exactly relation that we are going to see? Okay, so now see here, I have one more paper. Okay, so that I am using here, see, this is, I am adjusting here, and here I can see the line, so that I am increasing. See carefully everybody, so this is, here I can see the downside line, this line I can see upside, so I can increase this line. Okay, so now I am going to cut this. I am going to cut with the help of pair of scissors. Okay, so this now I am taking.
Okay, what is important here? Here angle is important. Okay, so see here carefully, I have taken here this angle, okay, which we can join exactly with this. Okay, so it is little more, so that I'm okay, so see here, this is angle C, this is angle C. Okay, now if we will the same angle, if we will put here, same angle we will put here, this way we will put here, then see some space is remaining. Okay, so see carefully, if I am marking here how much it is taking. Okay, now we will adjust this angle here, we will adjust this angle here. Okay, see once again here, this angle, this is okay, now we will put this angle here. Okay, you can see two times this angle, when you will take two times, that time AOB is formed. Okay, means if this angle is 60 degree, this angle is 60 degree, that time angle AOB will be definitely 120 degree. Okay, angle AOB will be 120 degree. So what is the result of this activity? AOB is equal to 2 times of ACB. AOB is equal to 2 times of angle ACB, or we can say ACB is equal to half of AOB. Okay, so here we can write that ACB, A angle ACB is equal to half of angle AOB. Okay, if ACB, AOB is suppose 120 degree, AOB suppose 120 degree, then what will be the measurement of ACB? What will be the measurement of ACB? ACB will be 60 degree. Okay, so the same property we can use. Suppose I will shift this C point here anywhere, then too the result is same. This angle, if I will take here, then two times I need to take. So this is very simple activity, and the name of this activity is angle subtended by the chord. Okay, so angle subtended by the chord on the circumference is half of the subtended by the with the center. Okay, so if this is 60 degree, keep in mind, if this is 60 degree, this will be 120 degree, or this is 120 degree, that time this is 60 degree. Okay, so see carefully and do this activity in your lab manual. Okay, and solve worksheet number 1 today. Okay, thank you.